In continuation with the graphs, let's see how to draw these functions. Number one is y equal to absolute value of fx. Okay. Now before we start, let's understand the meaning of what is absolute value of phi. It is phi. And absolute value of minus phi is also phi. So whatever is there inside absolute value results into positive only. Okay. Great. If a function y equal to fx looks like this, let's say there is some function 1 minus 2. How to draw the graph of y equal to absolute value of fx? Understand, just now we discussed whatever is there inside absolute value results into positive. It means this, whether fx is positive or negative, my y would always be positive, right? So my y would always be positive means even for negative of fx, because that is my part where fx is negative, right? Even for negative of fx, my y would become positive. So this part, which is negative fx, right, it should go on the upper part. Remember my friends, what I said, fx, whether it is positive or negative, y would always be positive. So for negative of the function, y has to become positive. So final graph looks like this. And what is this vertex? This would be 1, 2. I hope it is clear. Let's move on. If y equal to fx is a function, this function, how to draw y equal to f of absolute value of x? Now this time absolute value is on x. What does that mean? It means that whether x is positive or negative, my this part would always be positive, right? Whether x itself is positive or negative, my this part would always be positive. So my function would always follow the positive x values, right? So my function would always follow the positive x values. So this is the part where my x is positive, right? Even for negative of x, my function would follow, means my y value would be following the positive x values. It means the function y value would be same for positive x or for negative x. Repeating again, the y value would be same for positive x or for negative x. So graphically, this function is asymmetric about y axis, right? So final graph looks like this and this. The mirror image along y-axis, this point would become 1, minus 1, minus 2. So this is how my second graph looks like. Good. Let's come to third one. Now in third one, if a function is y equal to fx be this function, in third one, we are doing two things, absolute value on x as well as absolute value on fx. Now, absolute value of x means whether for positive x or for negative x, function would give the same y value, right? So, whether for positive x or for negative x, function would give the same y value. So dealing with absolute value of x, the graph looks like this. Now, absolute value of this part means my y would always be positive even for negative things, because anything inside modulus makes it positive. So anything inside modulus makes positive, so negative part would go on the positive part, would make it positive. So this was the negative part which converted into positive. So this is how the final graph looks like. It would be this and that and this and that. So this is my number 3 graph. Okay, good one. Let's move on for number 4. If there is some function y equal to fx which looks like this, how shall we draw absolute value of y is equal to fx? Now my friends, as I said, absolute value means the result should always be positive. So we understand fx should always be positive, right? Fx cannot be negative because this is absolute value. So negative of fx is rejected, that is not defined, correct? Absolute value of y is equal to fx, and we know that absolute value makes always positive, so this fx has to be positive. Negative of the fx is rejected. Okay, now absolute value y equal to fx, so y can attain two values of fx, plus fx or minus fx, correct? Remember, I am relating again, mod of 5 also gives 5 and modulus of minus 5 also gives 5, right? So this fx is the result which is similar to 5. So my y value can be positive or can be negative of fx. Good. If that is the case, y equal to positive of fx is this graph, you can see, right? How to draw y equal to negative of fx? Negative fx means my y would become negative, right? So this was my positive y. So y would become negative means it's a reflection along x-axis, correct? Understand my friends, y equal to positive fx is this graph and y equal to minus fx is this graph, and that is my final graph for number 4. Great, move on. If a function y equal to fx looks like this, how to draw mod of y is equal to mod of fx? Before we start, let me tell you, if mod of x equal to mod of 5, then we know that x equal to plus minus 5, right? We know that. So, following this, we can understand mod of y is equal to mod of fx. So, when we remove modulus from both sides, we can make y equal to plus minus fx, right? So, it means y equal to positive fx or y equal to negative fx, both will happen. So y equal to positive fx is already there, right, which is given in the function. Now what we need to draw is y equal to negative of fx. means my function would change its sign. My function would rotate along x-axis. So this is y equal to minus of fx, and this part is y equal to fx, which is already given. So my final graph for number 5 is this whole thing. This whole thing. All what you can see is my number 5 graph. I hope it is clear. Okay. Now, how to draw number 6? Number 6 is just an extension of number 5, if you can see. Here it is x. Means x can be anything, positive or negative. Here it is absolute value of x. Means this function should be symmetrical about y-axis. Thus, the figure on the right side of y will have same figure on the left side of y. Okay. So what does that mean? It means that I am drawing number 6 graph. I said figure on the right side of y. So this is the figure on the right side of y. Would have same figure on the left side of y, because this is absolute value of x. Right? Okay. So I am making this graph. I hope it is clear. Figure on the right side of y is same as figure on the left side of y. What I have rejected is the negative side of x. I have rejected because for positive x or negative x, mod of x would always be mod of anything. Mod of 5 would always be 5, and mod of minus 5 would also be 5. Right. So this is how number 6 graph looks like. Good. Let's do one more example of each of the graphs very fast. Now, if a function y equal to fx looks like this, how does number 1 looks like? My y should always be positive. So for negative, I will convert to positive thing, right? So it would be a reflection. So reflection would be like this. This will reflect to x-axis. So this is how number 1 graph would look like. Number 1. Okay. How would number 2 graph look like? Y equal to absolute value of f of x. Okay, f of absolute value of x. It means for positive x or negative x, figure would be same. Okay, it means the function would follow only the positive value of x. So this is the part where x is positive, right? So I will reject the negative part of x. So what I said, x is positive or negative, function would follow the positive side of x. Okay. So the graph would be symmetrical about y-axis. Correct? So this is how my final graph of number 2 looks like. Okay. How to draw number 3? If my graph is like this, again number 3 is extension of number 2, right? What extension? Why? Here function was, could be anything. Here function should always be positive. Anyway, in this graph, my function is already positive. It is never negative, right? So, this graph, third graph, would also look like the same, right? Third graph is the extension of number 2. Number 2 says function can be positive or negative. Whereas in this coincidentally function is always positive. My y value is always positive. So in number 3, y would always be positive anyway. So our final graph is this. Great. Let's see how does number 4 look like. If a function is y equal to fx, if it looks like this, so absolute value of y is equal to fx. I remember my friends, I would only accept the positive values of fx, right? I would not accept the negative values of fx. Why? Because absolute value of y always results into positive. So I would reject this. Correct? Now, this y can be written as positive fx or negative fx. Positive fx is, I can see this. My negative fx would be reflection along x-axis. So the graph would look like this. This would reflect along this. Let me draw it better. It would look like this. So my final graph of number 4 is this and this. Hope it is clear. On number 5. Number 5 is, I can see, if the graph is this. So number 5 means y equal to plus fx or y equal to minus fx. So anyway, y equal to plus fx is already given, drawn. Our job is just to draw y equal to minus fx. So we will just rotate it along x-axis. Positive y will change to negative y. Negative y will change to positive y. So this graph I am rotating. So this is how this graph is y equal to minus fx. And this graph is y equal to positive fx. So number 5 is this graph. This as well as this. Good. Number 6 is extension of number 5. What kind of extension? In number 5, x can be positive or negative. In number 6, it is absolute value of x. It means, even for positive or negative, the whole graph will follow the positive x pattern, right? It means, let me draw fresh for number 6. I said, whether x were positive or negative, the whole function would follow the positive x pattern. So positive x is this part and this part, correct? So even for negative x, graph would follow the same pattern like positive x. So what I did, I rejected the x negative thing from number 5. We are following the